Inshallah, my brothers, we're going to have a few beautiful talks, inspiring talks by brothers and by mashaykh, inshallah, and then we're going to end it with dua. So open your heart, open your mind. This could be the time that Allah Azza wa Jalla will close the gate of the hellfire on you and Allah will open the gate of the paradise for you. Let this moment be your moment. This is maybe the moment that Allah will look at you and say, oh my servant, I promise you that today I'll forgive you and have mercy upon you. And I promise you that you'll be from amongst those who enter the paradise behind Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe tonight is your night, my brother. Maybe tonight, this night is worth your whole life. A man will stand before Allah in the hereafter. And this man, Allah will say to him, oh my servant, you neglected me. You've disobeyed me. You were so occupied in this world and committing the haram. And then Allah says to him, you are going to the hellfire. But before you go to the hellfire, oh my servant, if you had this whole world full of gold, would you give me that in return for me to save you from the hellfire? So the reply of the servant of Allah will be, yes, ya Rab, everything but the hellfire. So Allah will say to him, oh my servant, you are a liar. I asked you for something smaller than that, and you did not even give it to me. My brothers, this could be your night. This is the night. This tonight could be the night that Allah Azza wa Jal opens your heart to Him. And this is the night that Allah Azza wa Jal will bestow His guidance upon you. So please open your heart, open your mind, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make you from amongst those that Allah Azza wa Jal accepts. Inshallah, we have our brother Abdul Hamid who will share something with you. Open your mind and heart, sit down, and I want every single person to be seated. I don't want to see one person standing. Everyone sit down, be part of this environment. I remind you of one thing. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting in one gathering, and three men came into this gathering. The first one came close to the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, and I want those brothers at Tabak to listen to this carefully. The second one sat at the end of the gathering. The third one walked away from the gathering. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, I want to tell you about those three men that just came into this gathering. The one that came close to me, he came close to Allah, so Allah became close to him. And I want to tell you about the one that sat at the end of the gathering. He was shy from Allah, Allah was shy from him. And I want to tell you about the one that walked away from the gathering. He walked away from Allah, so Allah Azza wa Jal walked away from him. Don't be from that. I want everyone to be seated. And I want everyone to stay seated. And I want everyone to open their minds. And I want everyone to open their hearts. The only thing I want you to switch off is your phone. So switch off your phone, inshallah.
Brothers, I want to talk to you today about a man, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the praised one, Aisha radiallahu anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She shares with us a very personal moment in her life. She says, one day I was with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was in a cheerful mood. So I said to him, ya Rasulullah, make dua for me. So he said, Allahumma ighfir li Aisha. May Allah forgive Aisha. Ma taqaddama min dhanbiha wa ma ta'akhkhara. And he continued, oh Allah, forgive Aisha. All her sins, the past sins, the future sins, the ones that she commits in private and the ones that she commits in public. And Aisha was so happy that she started to laugh. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked her, did that dua please you? Brothers, I want you to imagine that you were living at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was your best friend, and you asked him, make dua for me, and he made the same dua for you. How happy would you be? So he says to Aisha, did that dua please you? She says, ya Rasulullah, how could that not please anyone? He says, wallahi, by Allah, إِنَّهَا لَدَعْوَةِ لِأُمَّةِ فِي كُلِّ صَلَاةِ. He says, by Allah, that is the same dua I make for my ummah in every single one of my prayers. The Prophet ﷺ made that same dua for you. How much did the Prophet ﷺ love us? He would cry in front of the Sahabi. He would cry and he would say, I miss my brothers, the ones that I love. And they would say, ya Rasulullah, aren't we your brothers? He would say, no, you are my companions. But my brothers are the ones that will come after me, and they will believe in me, and they would never have seen me. This is you, brothers. The Prophet ﷺ is crying because he misses you. He would stay the night praying to Allah, crying out to Allah, my ummah, ummati, ummati. The Prophet ﷺ is crying for you. When was the last time you cried for the Prophet ﷺ? The Prophet would give khutbah and he would lean on a tree as he would give the khutbah. Until they built him the minbar. The following week, standing on this minbar, the companions would say, we heard the tree crying like it was a little baby. The tree was crying because it missed Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If this tree, brothers, this tree which is not a living thing, is not obligated to love Rasulullah, was crying because it missed Rasulullah. And other people who say Muhammad is Rasulullah, are we not more worthy to cry for missing him than this tree? Are we not worthy? The companions would sacrifice so much. When the Prophet ﷺ passed away, and Bilal, the one who would call the adhan, he could not do it anymore. He would sit in the Prophet's mosque, and he would imagine looking at the house of Aisha, which was the grave of the Prophet ﷺ, and he would imagine the Prophet walking across the rawda and saying to Bilal, Arihna biha ya Bilal. Comfort us with it, ya Bilal. Make the adhan for prayer. And so Bilal could not stand living in the city of Medina without Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every street, every corner, every rock, everything would remind him this is where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. So he leaves the city, as many companions did, going for jihad. Until many years later, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave victory to the Muslims in Jerusalem, and the Sahaba would be reunited for the first time in so long since the death of the Prophet. And they would see Bilal, who had not given adhan for 6 years. And they would say to him, ya Bilal, adhin lana, make adhan for us just one last time. And he would say, fa'adhurin, please, I can't, it's too painful. They would say, please, they ask Umar, ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, please speak to him. Until Umar spoke to him and he agreed. And so Bilal would get up to make this adhan. The first time since the death of the Prophet ﷺ. And he would call the adhan. The memories, the sweet times, the fragrance of the Rasulullah, his warmth, his compassion would come back to the Sahaba and they would all cry. Could you imagine Umar crying like a little child? And Bilal would struggle through the adhan and he would continue until he would get to the part in the adhan, Ashhadu anna Muhammada Rasulullah, until he would break down and cry. And he could not continue either. Many years later, when Bilal was on his deathbed, dying, and his wife would say to him, what sorrow, what sorrow, he would say, no, what happiness, what happiness, what joy, for tomorrow I will be with the one that I love, I will be with Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How many of us cry for Rasulullah? How many of us love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam like the way he should be loved? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلْ سَيْءَ مُحَمَّدٍ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِ يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Say, O Muhammad, if you truly love Allah, tell the people, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. Follow Muhammad, and Allah will love you. وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Allah forgive you your sins. For Allah to love you, you need to love Allah. And to love Allah, you need to follow the Prophet ﷺ. How much do the companions love the Prophet ﷺ? And yet the Prophet ﷺ said, from amongst the ones who love me the most, the ones who love me the most will be a people who will come after me, having never seen me. And yet they will wish they can sacrifice their wealth and their families just to see me once. Just to see me once. Brothers, do we love Rasulullah? Do we have his sunnah in our life? Do we follow his example? Do we cry for missing him? For how much he sacrificed for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us.
Jazakallah khair, brother. This is a great reminder to know the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in our lives. And that love should not just be talk, but should be action. The love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is claimed by everyone. That we all love the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. But when it comes to reality, our actions are totally in contrary with the actions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And look, subhanAllah, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has not even yet met us, and he is so eager to meet us. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And he says in one hadith that every Prophet was given an accepted dua, and every Prophet had used that accepted dua in this world, and I had kept my accepted dua in the hereafter for my nation. For who? For me and you. Why? Why? What do we owe the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? What does he owe us that we have to, he's got to do this for us? We owe him everything. Our iman and love is connected to him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the hereafter, when people will be going from one Prophet to another Prophet, from Adam to Nuh to Ibrahim to Musa to Isa, and each one Prophet they go to, they ask him to say, ask Allah azza wa jal to resort to Allah to make things easier on them on that day. A day where there's nothing easy. A day where it's so hard. A day where the pregnant woman will give birth to her child, and the breastfeeding mother will cast her child. A day that you run away from your own mother and your own father and your own daughter and your own son and your own brother. A day where everyone says nafsi, nafsi, including the prophets and messengers. They will say nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. I am not made for this. I am not made for this. Until they get to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And there the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam will say, I am the one that's made for this. I am the one that will ask Allah. I am the one that will resort to Allah. I am the one that will supplicate to Allah. And will prostrate under the throne of Allah. And ask Allah azza wa jal to make easy on him and his nation. And then Allah tells Muhammad, put your head up and ask, you'll be given. And intercede will accept your intercession. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam, in a day and a moment where everyone's worried about himself, including the prophets and the messengers, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will say, Ya Rab, Ummati, Ummati, my nation, my nation. Who's the nation of Muhammad? It's me and you. In a moment where sallallahu alayhi wasalam is so worried and concerned about us in this world, and the hereafter, we're not even concerned about him in this world, nor in the hereafter. We take others as examples. We take the Hollywood kuffar actors as examples. We take those junkies of the street and the gangsters on the street as examples. And we forget the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Muhammad, put your head up, ask, you'll be given an intercede to accept your intercession. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam says, Ya Rab, my nation, my nation. So Allah azza wa jal will say, we will take out of the hellfire anyone that had iman equal to the weight of a seed of wheat. And a second time the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam prostrate to Allah, he wants more. And Allah Azza wa Jal told him, put your head up and ask, you'll be given intercede to accept your intercession. And again for the second time, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam will say, Ya Rab, Ummati, Ummati, my nation, my nation. So Allah will say to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam, we will take out of the hellfire anyone who had iman equal to the weight of an atom. And the third time, sallallahu alayhi wasallam will prostrate to Allah and ask Allah to make it easy on him and his nation. And Allah will say to him, oh Muhammad, put your head up and ask, you'll be given. And intercede will accept your intercession. And there the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam will say, Ya Rab, Ummati, Ummati, I want more than what you had given me. So Allah will say to Muhammad, oh Muhammad, this is was not meant to happen, but we'll make it happen for you. And because of you, it will happen. So take out of the hellfire anyone who ever said La ilaha illallah. Anyone who ever said La ilaha illallah. Why? Because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Not because of you or your wealth or your strength or my wealth or my strength. It is because of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So my brothers, how much do you really care about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam?